I'm also really trying to make it like really quality. Like, I mean, you know, my best stuff ever. It doesn't make a difference who's publishing it and stuff like that. So, you know.
You know, you can do Batman, you can do Superman, you can do something called Rocket Girl if you want. And she's like, Rocket Girl, that's what we're doing. And it's like, well,
What's Rocket Girl?
Yeah, it's like, it was just, again, a placeholder.
Well, first of all, yeah, Rocket Girl is about a teen cop from the future. She goes back in time to the 80s to fight crime, and she basically...
Corruption, mostly, huh?
Yeah, and corruption, but also crime, right?
Yeah, she does.
She takes care of a lot of people. But her future with like flying cars and all that stuff is actually 2013. So it's this alternate future that we kind of imagined would have happened back in the 80s, but just hasn't happened and everybody's wondering why. First, it just started with the title Rocket Girl, and Brandon was just using it as an example of how you should never just start with a title.
Yeah.
But then I made him because he used the title Rocket Girl and I liked it so much.
To me, the funniest thing about the 80s, it's just like being on the phone and you're not being able to get anything because it's connected to the cord and it's like, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So even to me, just like phones in the 80s is like an interesting...
It's hilarious.
I think it's hilarious, but maybe not, hopefully. You know, funnier than piano ties and... feathered hair.
Yeah.
Although we'll have piano ties and feathered hair too. So. It really just started as Rocket Girl. Amy, yeah. You know, completely did the design, which is...
Well, you added the cool, like, police lights. That's the coolest part of the costume.
I added the cool police lights
to
the costume. You, as a writer, you want to do something that Amy's going to be strong. I know she's going to be excited with a female lead character.
Yeah.
Younger, you know what I mean? So that's easy. Anybody can guess that Amy wants to do that. Knowing her a little better, it's like, well, let's do a time travel element. Let's do it in the 80s. Let's do some other stuff, and you know.
And it's definitely like the coolest thing I've gotten to draw ever. And of course, I'm like inking it, I'm coloring it, so that's kind of its own beast. And that's something that I'm learning. You know, I first started coloring myself on interiors with Halloween Eve, and it's a different art doing that versus illustrations. Coloring for pages. So yeah, I'm kind of learning as I go along and figuring out what effects I can leave for colors and which ones don't really work unless you draw it first and stuff like that. And I'm also lettering the book. So that's another reason that we're pretty collaborative with the story, right? Because even though he writes the words, I'm the one who's placing them. And so anyway, yeah, it's definitely a very collaborative effort, but still kind of traditional.
Yeah, and a bigger world than anything you've had to do before.
But see, to me, this doesn't even seem like a period piece in the sense that, like, period pieces are more like longing for the past.
Right.
But this is really about our present. Like, I mean, that's the cool thing I think about it, is that the reason why we're using that time is specifically because times have changed so much since then, but they've changed in a completely different way.
Right,
and,
yeah, that was
kind of... And so it's more about, like... about predictions of like how things are going to come about and what that says about the 80s and what that says about us now.
Yeah. I know Amy kind of likes the 80s.
I mean, a lot
of people do. So it's
I
like,
held
you know,
on to them kind of late though. Oh, so in a way, I'm more legit than it sounds.